In this edition of Inside Blue Hose Basketball, pretty decent week for Presbyterian College basketball team as they tangle with the Eagles of Winthrop and then come home and face Montreat. We'll have a visit with Coach Greg Nybert. Take a look at those highlights and a lot more in this edition of Inside Blue Hose Basketball.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Basketball is brought to you by
Founders Federal Credit Union. Relax, you're with Founders. By Self Regional Healthcare, we bring advanced care closer. By Fats Cafe of Clinton, making your tailgate deliciously easy. And by Coca-Cola, the official soft drink of Presbyterian College.
We welcome you to this edition of Inside Blue Hose Basketball, along with the coach, Greg Nybert. I'm your host, Eric Thacker. Glad that you could spend this Saturday with us. Coach, it's still part of the early season for your basketball team, but we've already had a couple of conference games. Tell us what you like about this team as the early part of this season compared to last year, if you would, please.
Well, we're better defensively, even though we didn't show it in the Gardner-Webb game. But I was so proud of our guys responding. We had two great days of practice Thursday and Friday leading into Winthrop. We know they were one of the hottest teams in the league and only lost by to NC State and had a young man score 38 points against NC State, Gavin. So we knew our hands were full with Keon Johnson and him. And we did a much better job of on-ball screen defense and just really went over there and played much better defense, and I think that's where we're farther along compared to last year's team.
You know, talking about the young man that scored over 30 points against the Wolfpack of NC State, Gavin. Gavin was pretty much shut down in that contest.
Well, we did. I was real proud of Reggie Dillard and Jaron, who really did it. Jaron drew a charge on him and unfortunately got away from us on two baseline out-of-bounds plays. I think he had 6 points on two baseline out-of-bounds plays, and that really hurt us, but overall, Reggie and Jaron did a tremendous job and had a chance to win that game with 2 minutes and 38 seconds to go. We're up one, and we just got a few plays defensively, like I say, play a little better, help defense, play without fouling is really, hurting us, putting these guys on the free throw line and a couple blockouts. But we're right there defensively, and we're scoring more points than we have in a long time, but we just got to keep improving defensively.
Absolutely, and again, the defense played really well in that contest. At an arena that's a very tough arena because Winthrop gets behind their team, they cheer their team on, and they're very good at home. So playing on the road the way your Blue Hose did was exciting, and you've always said, hey, hold serve, win at home, and then try to steal a couple on the road. And now it looks like this team has the capability of maybe doing that this year.
Well, I think there's no question about it, Eric. Mm-hmm. We're a young basketball team. Sometimes we're all there on all cylinders, like the Citadel game. Mm-hmm. But there's nothing but getting better every time we play. But we're a little inconsistent sometimes with our defense. And we did a much better job taking care of the basketball and scored 70 points at Winthrop. Usually you'd say we would win, but we're right in there. We're just a missed block out or two or not fouling or making a shot or two, and we're 1-1. So.
Offensively, on the offensive side of the ball, Coach, Deshaun Murray. Hmm. And folks, again, if you have not seen this electric sophomore play, you need to check this guy out. Not one of the better ones in the conference, but in mid-major basketball as well. This guy is so unstoppable on the block, and now he's improved his shooting range as well, becoming a complete offensive threat for the Blue Hose. Tell us what you think about Deshaun.
Well, he's just a guy that has tremendous energy and only 6'3 or 6'4, but really unbelievable score down there on the block and really shoot over people. They would double team him, but he's really getting about 24 or 25 a night. We got to keep him out of foul trouble, and people are double teaming, but he's had a couple silly fouls every game, and we got to keep him out there playing. And Ed Drew coming off the bench, so we got two really nice four men, but what a start he's having, and just so proud of his effort and getting better defensively, guarding the ball and blocking out and things. We need those things from him, but what an unbelievable offensive start he's had.
And in terms of our five men, getting better, very young, Austin Venable is going to be a force on the block in games to come this year and in the future for Presbyterian College. Well, Coach, let's go ahead and dive in. PC and Winthrop.
Game highlights are brought to you by Matt Davis State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, Matt Davis and State Farm are there.
Well, we really went over there. The stressing was the defense. We put in a few set plays, which we ran a set play right here, almost a legal screen there by Reggie, but he was trying. We missed Austin down there on the block. We then go into our passing game, swinging the basketball, getting the ball down inside to Deshaun, and just great, you know, move down there in the lane. Cooks hurt him, you know, we played there last year. Great back screen there, down screen, go inside to Deshaun. He's double teamed again and takes it right to Cooks, and Cooks can't stop him.
And he played Cooks well that entire game.
Yeah. Again, defensively here, we do a great hedge there, you know, on the ball with Deshaun, which we didn't do against Gardner-Webb. Great job there, going back with your hands up again, Austin Venable. That was what was taught, and just did it perfectly. And Marcus was on the tape. Again, great job of not fouling, okay? And then good defense leads to great offense. And what a play that was right there by Austin Venable, freshman to freshman. That was what was exciting about there. Darius to his roommate, Austin, and what a bright future that is. Again, we take in the secondary. Great pass by Marcus. And then great shot by Janiel Jenkins, and great pickup right there. That's what we want every play, is after you score, is picking their point guard up full floor. Again, another little set play we put in, run him to the block, going down inside.
There's that left hand
right on that block, which is absolutely awesome. Again, on ball screen by Austin, driving it off. Need to take it off a little further. Marcus does. Again, on ball screen. Again, we're kind of going to a little shot clock play. Great pull-up three by Marcus as the shot clock's going down. We get Marcus playing better, help defense. He's really, you know, doing well. Again, Ed in there, on-ball screen, drive it off, swing it. Again, shot clock's going down. We go to, you know, 1-4. Again, great pull-up there, you know, there in the ending of the first half. It's all 38-all at halftime. Again, set play to open up the second half. Again, there's what we want right there.
Yes, sir.
And we got to get more of that from Reggie. But he took his time. He was wide open. He prepared himself. He's shooting the ball too fast. But there you can see when he takes his time. Great hedging over there. Great help there by Marcus. All right. And a great charge by Jaron.
And you coach taking those charges.
Oh, yeah. You got to take charges.
Well, Coach, hey, just give us a chance to win at the end. The Blue Hose led most of the game. Actually, they lost the lead for a moment, was able to recapture it. But there again, at the end of the game, a chance to win.
Well, we did. And we're up one with 2 minutes and 38 seconds to go and have the basketball. And you know, we make one more shot. We go up four. Reggie had a wide open shot there, but he, you're going to miss some of those shots.
That was a good look.
It was a great look, but then you got to go down there and make a few stops. Mm-hmm. And we had again some. We got to quit fouling. They shot 41. They had 41 attempts.
Incredible.
And you can't guard people on that free throw line. We've got to just do a much better job of guarding the ball without fouling, not having any silly fouls, and then we got to do a better job of our help defense when people drive. But to have a chance to win on the road is what this, and in the right way. We had some good defensive plays, really played well on offense, and Deshaun had a tremendous game, but we have a chance to win the game, and that's what's exciting.
And oh, by the way, the Winthrop Eagles, a very good quality team as of today. They are a leading conference play. Well, when we come back after this timeout, the Blue Hose return home to the Templeton Center, and they entertain Montreat. How would they come out after that close loss to Winthrop? We'll take a look at those highlights, plus award our offensive and defensive and hustle player of the week. All ahead here on Inside Blue Hose Basketball.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Basketball is brought to you by
Bojangles, it's bow time. And by Jeff Smith, Allstate Insurance of Clinton. You're in good hands with Jeff Smith and Allstate.
We're fighting cancer with caring, with technology, with knowledge, and now with the Hollings Clinical Trial Network at the Medical University of South Carolina. Together, we're bringing more advanced cancer care close to home. Self Regional Healthcare Cancer Center. We bring advanced care closer.
Think that sign says?
Eat more ch. What is ch?
Well, it's the start of a word. Something like eat more cheese or eat more chili.
Chocolate, eat more chocolate.
No, it's chowder.
Chimichangas.
Cheesecake.
Chewing gum. It could be chewing gum.
That's not how you spell chicken. I'm pretty sure.
Half lemonade, half ice cream. Frosted lemonade, starting at 240 calories.
We welcome you back to Inside Blue Hose Basketball with head coach Greg Nybert. And coach, we've seen Montreat a couple of times now in your tenure. Is this a team that we're going to see, as part of non-conference play after year?
We might. We might want to switch it around a little bit and even play some South Carolina non-D1 schools and things like that. But
you like to keep it within the state.
They got a new coach. They really got some athletic kids and we didn't come out exactly like we wanted to come out in the first half, but I got it going, made some shots the second half. Guys came off the bench, which was really exciting, and get a 24-point win. But our defense needs to still continue to improve. We talked about, Marcus Terry playing more better help defense. He still has to do it, and there were some still laws in there, but I was really proud of he put some effort in, and we were better defensively the second half.
All righty, let's go ahead and dive in. PC and Montreat.
Game highlights are brought to you by
we good defense there and got a steal, pitched the ball ahead, but great steal there by Austin playing the ball and great pitch ahead by Marcus to Reggie. Again, another help defense. We really talked about helping on defense. Austin makes a great play there. Again, secondary break. We probably need to swing in the basketball. Run a little back screen for Deshaun, step out, again, swing the basketball. Great left-handed feed, up top there by Devon, roommate to roommate. Again, good guard the ball there. Great help there by Deshaun on the help, and he's one of the fastest guys probably in the country, taking that ball. Again, baseline out of bounds, great back screen, and then we talked about looking for that back screen and had great spacing, great pass, and great screen by Reggie. Again, they miss. Great pass ahead. Unfortunately, we go a little too far, but great saved and by Austin. It goes to Deshaun, and just by his hustle, again, taking the ball to the secondary, swinging the ball, staggering away. Ball goes down inside. Again, want to move the ball from side to side. Did a little bit faster. I like the help. We need to sprint. Again, get the ball over here on this block. Great right-handed hook there by John Majors coming off the bench. Good build a wall and great cover down. Again, playing help defense. Again, good defense leading to great offense. And a way to pass the ball, Marcus there and Darius. Again, another miss. You can see we're all around the ball. We haven't been that lately. Again, Darius pitches it out there to Will. Will missed some shots in the first half, but he's one of the best shooters on the team. Again, we missed it down there in the post. Again, we need to get our post players flashing high. There we go, right there, looking in, looking opposite. Great pass right there, and being ready to shoot, and Will knock some shots down in the second half. I believe it was 2 for 2, 2 for 3. Great drive there by Darius, who had a tremendous, tremendous game. Darius did. Again, another turnover, Reggie, and great dunk there by Reggie. But again, good defense leading to great offense. Another denying there, great save. Job by Ed. And again, we get a layup down there at the other end with Marcus Terry. And Steven Osu there. We got some guys in the game there at the end. Great shot
there
by
Steven. Good to see Steven in there.
again, we play in good defense. Charlie gets a steal. And this Charlie's in that gym more than anybody, pushing in there, left-hand bank shot. That was so awesome by the bench.
Charlie Ainkley.
Puller Freed. We're so proud of Charlie. He's one of the hardest workers on the team. We had a nice win there after a tough loss there on Saturday. The guys bounced back and ready to go for finals.
Well, Coach, no doubt about it. You are a big fan of your bench, and you really do enjoy games that see everybody on the bench get into the game, not only play, but contribute as well.
Well, it was great. We really did have great play off the bench, and I was really proud of Darius. You know, Devon started, and but Darius had a great game. Janiel came in there and did some nice things. Really proud of Will Adams and Jaron. He's just bringing his defense every time, and Ruben and Ed and John Majors, Steven, all of them. Charlie Harrison, and I mean, it was great. We're redshirting Jeff Gandy. That's the reason he didn't get in the game. But
right,
so proud of all of them. We got the best bench we've ever had, and since we've been Division I.
Boy, there's no doubt about that. I also like the rotation that you found with this team, because with that depth, it really allows Presbyterian College to play the entire game, and the fatigue factor not playing a part of the Blue Hose. Will, Coach, you coach defensive first. And now it's time to go ahead and award our Defensive Player of the Week, brought to you by Steve Crow and Foothills Motorsports.
Well, it all starts with defense here, and that was the thing we were most proud of. You say we got a 6-point lead here and getting ready to go to 8. What a great on-ball screen defense there. And Deshaun getting his hands on that basketball. And we work on coming over there and saving the ball from out of bounds. But just really kind of three great players right there. Austin and Deshaun and Reggie really playing that great on-ball screen defense.
Well, a great job by the Blue Hose there defensively. OKK, they were trying to get him down on the block and anticipating that pass. And that's another thing, Coach, that we have seen is that the Blue Hose are now starting to attack those passing lanes and starting to get their hands in there.
Yeah, we sure are. Couldn't have been prouder of our team. And we know we could win that game, and hopefully maybe might see Winthrop in the Big South tournament.
Oh, that would be great, Coach. Now let us go ahead and transition to our Offensive Player of the Week, and that's brought to you by Swain Brown and Associates and Carolina Insurance Consultants.
Well, you can see we got the ball out of bounds there, sideline out of bounds. We call a set play here coming out of the timeout. Again, we're running, set a little UCLA cut, going right into the on-ball screen, and a great pass. We knew they hedged hard at both of them, brought the other post player out there, and Ed made a tremendous pass to Austin for a great offensive execution there.
Well, Coach, great offense is set up by how you screen, how your spacing is, and how well you're able to pass the ball, and then you got to finish the play.
Well, we did, and we ran a little play there, and Austin Venable set a great screen. On-ball screen, which got the guard open, and made a great pass to Ed, and Ed makes a great pass to Austin, but it all started with, again, a great screen first by Austin and getting somebody open, and Ed distributing that ball.
All righty, Coach, this is one of our favorite parts of Inside Blue Hose Basketball, the Hustle Award. I know you had to pound it really hard because you had a lot of players this past week that were deserving of that award. And this is presented by our friend Coach Dan Nunnery, who used to be a player here and was one of Greg's assistant coaches at one time. This is our Hustle Player of the Week.
Well, we really had some really great hustle plays here in this game, and really guarding the basketball. Again, good job right there. Great help defense. We got everybody get helping. And watch this play right here. Great defense leading an unbelievable offense, and that needs it. No doubt that needs 100% right there with that great defense by Reggie Dillard.
Well, Coach, hustle could either go to compliment a defensive play or it could go to compliment an offensive play, and Reggie Dillard did both there.
Well, he did, and we really tell all our guys, it all starts with defense, and if you can always have a great defensive game, and that help off that ball that Reggie did there got him that steal, and then he went down and finished with an unbelievable dunk with a guy coming from behind. And we need some more of those plays by everybody, because we really need to play the ball, and it can't just be certain guys. Everybody's got to play that basketball.
When we come back, Coach, and we are going to talk about the health of the team with our Palmetto Bone and Joint Injury Report, I want you to talk a little bit about Reggie Dillard, what he did last year to get his knee ready for this year, and where he is with that progress. First, let's go ahead and take a timeout, and when we come back, the aforementioned Palmetto Bone and Joint Injury Report and the Bear Transport look ahead. Huge game, the Clemson Tigers. And a lot of fans from Presbyterian College and fans in general looking forward to this matchup, which will be in the Bon Secours Arena in Greenville Tuesday night at 7. All that ahead here on Inside Blue Hose Basketball.
I'm a random windstorm. Shaky, 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 shaky. Shaky, shaky. And if you got cut rate insurance, you could be picking up this tab yourself. So get Allstate. You could save some cash and be better protected from mayhem like me.
As you set your financial game plan, we'll be with you every play. Relax, you're with Founders.
There once was a family, a lot like this one, and they were traveling far away where there were no Bojangles. The family needed breakfast, but they got a late start. They pulled up to a drive-thru of a strange restaurant, and a loud voice boomed, "We stopped serving breakfast at 10 a.m.
Oh, honey. At Bojangles, we've always served breakfast all day. Come in for a Cajun filet biscuit today. Bojangles, it's bow time.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Basketball is brought to you by
Matt Davis State Farm Insurance of Clinton. Like a good neighbor, Matt Davis and State Farm are there. Cooper Motor Company, sales and service of Chrysler, Jeep, Dodge, and Ram trucks since 1938. Chick-fil-A of Lawrence, home of the original chicken sandwich.
We welcome you back to Inside Blue Hose Basketball, and Coach, now it's time to take a look at our Palmetto Bone and Joint Injury Report. And again, I think we're okay there, aren't we?
Yeah, we're good. And Nelson Jones and Dr. Milner and his staff, right now we're looking good, and hopefully we can, you know, stay healthy and not have any, you know, major injuries. I think there might be some sniffles and some colds out there with the change of weather, but right now we're really good, Eric.
It's always better to give a pill or a little bit of a drink outside of having to worry about tendons and bones and all of that, for sure. Reggie Dillard, you lost him last year, and that was such a tough year last year because your team suffered so many injuries. You know, this player was out, this player was out, this player was out. Reggie Dillard out all year last year, now has come back. How has his transition been coming back?
Well, it's been awesome, man. Nelson Jones and Dr. Milner and his rehab and doctors up there in Greensboro where he's from, but especially Nelson and Dr. Milner and done a tremendous job with his work over the spring and the summer and getting him back. I think he got cleared around August, and you know, his knee is 100%. It's probably even better than the other knee, but I think he expects a lot out of himself, but you know, we gotta, you know, take it slow and but again, as you can tell by that dunk that he went off that knee, and he's really you know, been out a year, but you can really never tell it.
Yeah, and that was one heck of a flush dunk there by Reggie Dillard. Now it's time to transition to our Bear Transport look ahead.
Next week's preview is sponsored by Baird Transport for all your logistical and material transport needs.
All righty, Coach. Big, big, big. Tuesday night, 7 o'clock. The excitement's going to be there because all of Presbyterian College is going to be there. This is a huge stage for your young basketball team and a chance for people to experience your team and take a look at DeSean Murray and some of your other players.
Well, it is. And, you know, it's right after finals, which in the, probably the best time to schedule. But obviously when you're playing those guarantee games, right. We had to play exactly when they wanted to play. And you probably want to have a little easier game right after finals. But you know, we'll be ready to go, and we've, you know, had some great practices in terms of getting ready, and we'll really need to be ready because Obviously, Coach Brownell does a tremendous job, and they're very well schooled defensively, and played Alabama on I believe it was Sunday, and leading into our game on Tuesday at 7. But they also played Wofford, which is our kind of common, and USC Upstate, and they put it on both those people. So we'll really have to be ready, especially the beginning of the game, as they're probably going to try to really jump on us and defensively make us turn the ball over. So turnovers and taking care of that ball, especially in the first 4 minutes, is going to be big.
All righty, Coach. We look forward to it. Tuesday night at the Bon Secours Wellness Arena, 7 o'clock tip, PC and Clemson. For the Coach Greg Nybert, I'm your host, Eric Thacker. Until we see you next time, go Blue Hose.
Inside Blue Hose Football was brought to you by Smith Chevrolet of Lawrence, providing premier new car sales and service in Lawrence for over 60 years. By Palmetto Bone & Joint, the official orthopedic care provider for PC Athletics. And by Carolina Fresh Farms, the official turf grass of Presbyterian College. We would like to thank the following Blue Hose Honor Roll sponsors: The Bud Group, Good Times Entertainment, Carolina Concrete, Enterprise Rent-A-Car, Midway Barbecue, Hannah Heating and Air Conditioning, Epting Turf and Tractor, Arthur State Bank, Carolina Auto Sales of Clinton, Wilson's Cafe, Tony's Pizza, and Steamer's Cafe.